Hello friends, welcome back. This will be a small video regarding the macro capability of the Mate 20 Pro. Mate 20 Pro is a phone which has excited me a lot after a long time. I think V30 was another phone started with LG G5 actually, which was having a nice implementation of the wide angle camera, and I was really excited to try a lot of different viewpoints for the wide angle camera. But Mate 20 Pro excels in almost everything. It has a normal angle lens, a telephoto lens, as well as a wide angle lens. The special feature about this wide angle lens is that it can go extremely close to a subject called as a super macro mode. So today I'll be taking you through few of my pictures. They're not artistic enough. I just shot them to give you the viewpoint of how close you can go to a subject rather than being artistic. And I've already compared it with a normal viewpoint, I mean the 1x zoom, to show how close you can get to a subject with this macro lens. So let's start the video. So the first video, first photo I want to show you, this letter warning to prevent serious injury and all. So this photo you can see. So the first photo, this is a green background photo with a text written on it. This is taken with the normal 1x zoom lens, and we'll try to get as close to the subject as possible. You can see this is with full zoom how it is appearing. This, okay, now I'll show you the result of the macro lens. Yeah, you can see how close I have got to the text written in this. There may be slight coloring issues because with this macro lens, when it goes very close to the subject, it is difficult to control the lighting and the color. So sometimes I see there are a few color issues, color change issues. But here you can see how nicely it has rendered the textures and all, which is not visible in the normal lens. Now let's come to this photo. This is the regular lens. You can see how close we can get with the zoom and all. You can see. So this was shot with this 1x lens, and this is the wide angle super macro mode. You can see the dust particles also in this photo. You can see how close we can get into the subject and retains the details. It's quite phenomenal what this lens is doing actually. So this was a regular normal perspective of a 1x lens. You can see the color issues I was talking about. This is the 1x zoom lens, and you can see it has nicely retained the green color and hues, whereas once I go to the I had to hold it with my hands actually, because it was windy out there. So you can see the veins of the leaves are quite visible, but you can see there is slight green color was not exactly appearing green here. I had to take 2-3 shots to get the green color. It was kind of appearing black and white. So this is the normal. Okay, now this is one more photo I want to show. This is a sofa texture I wanted to demonstrate here. So with this 1x lens with maximum zoom, you can see this much is the resolution that we can get, whereas with this macro lens you can see the extremely thin fibers are also visible. You can see the resolution and the details retained in this photo. Okay, so this is another train which is there. I shot this with a 1x lens, normal lens. You can see there is a lot of detail retained also. Now let's go into this area of the clock. I'll show you. Okay, now you see how detailed and how close we can go to the subject with this macro mode. This is just a demonstration what you can do with this lens. One more shot, because this one came out slightly hazy, so I had to take another shot. So as said, uh, A good photo cannot be taken with a single attempt. It has to be tried one or two times, then only you can get a good photo. It's true for all cameras. This is again a normal perspective of the 1x lens. This you can see again a macro photo. I'll give the 1x perspective later on. You see how detailed the grains and all has been retained on the table, and this is the car. So this is the closest I could go with the 1x lens. Now once more, this is one small elephant which I have captured with the macro lens. You can see how much resolution is maintained. All the spider cobwebs, everything is visible in this photo. And since this is a wide angle lens, you won't get an extremely shallow depth of field. For that, I think a 3x zoom implementation would have been better. But anyway, I'm not complaining at all because these capabilities are phenomenal right now. This is the actual 1x lens as close as I could get. See, the actual focus point was here, focus point was not here, so this came out slightly hazy because it was slightly windy and it was moving around. So you can see this is the normal perspective of a 1x zoom lens, I mean 1x lens, and this is the macro capability of the wide angle lens. Okay, next, let's go to the next photo. See again how close I can go to these things. And one thing to remember is it is very difficult to capture a macro lens, a macro photo, because the lens goes so close. If the light is coming from the opposite end, so it is very difficult to control the light falling on the subject, because you are very close and shadows form from this camera to the subject. So this is the normal view and this is the macro view. Let's go to the next photo. Okay, this is a normal view, but resolution is extremely well maintained here. You can see here it is nicely maintained, all resolution, the thin veins, the hairs in the leaf, everything is nicely maintained. This is a high resolution photo, I feel, very sharp. I'll show you the zoom. You can see the zoom, how close I have gone to the leaf, and let's see the details. You can see here the pores and all, everything is visible in the photo. I think I could have gone little more closer. I didn't try that. My mistake, I think, because I think the zoom lens, I mean the wide angle lens, can go still further closer to this leaf. Just have a look how detailed the photos are. You can see even though these are very detailed, the depth of field is not very shallow, so you can still see the leaf below. You see here, and something in the background is still visible. It is kind of busy, it is not very shallow. So that is a small demerit, but I think in smartphone world very few phones will rival this capability of the Mate 20 Pro. After a long time, I'm seeing a camera capable enough of taking such close photos. Samsung was known to take a lot of macro photos, but recently I felt a Note 9 was kind of limited in that issue. I have taken multiple photos to get a good result. Okay, now these are two bears, pandas, which I got. I love Coney and I love brown, so I'll focus the ears on the brown panda. Let's see how close I can get. See, I have got very close, but since it was not a good lighting, so you can see it came out slightly hazy, or maybe I went too close. I'm not showing the best photos because I want to show you how many photos you have to take to get a good close-up photo. Okay, now this is the closest I could go because otherwise I was getting a lot of shadows, so I had to position it correctly to get this angle right. You can see how close and how detailed the shots are. Almost all the grains, everything is visible here. One more, this also came out slightly blurry. Now you see another one, how close it is. This one came out fine. You can see the black marks and all the grains in this. And it actually, the artificial intelligence mode kicks in and it shows you that this is a panda. Okay. So this is the close up of a 2 rupee coin of India. You can see how fine it is, how sharp it is. You can just see. Since I've taken multiple photos to get a sharp one. And this is a 5 rupee coin. Let's zoom in and see how detailed it is. You can see all the rough markings, the abuse that the 5 rupee coin has taken over the years from 2016 onwards. Yeah. Now this again the 5 rupee coin on the reverse, on the front side. Satyameva Jayate, Bharat, India. Everything is sharp, everything is soft, you can see. Now you can see how close I have gone to a pen tip. This is incredible actually. After a long time, I'm really excited. This is kind of cringy. I'll move on. Yeah. So this is my Boya mic which I use. You can see here, this is a close-up shot. And see the details. See the details in the letters. I don't think it is visible to a naked eye also, unless we go very close to. You can see there is some amount of purple fringing here around the bright subjects. Here you see. That's fine for this kind of a lens and small lens. Even a DSLR won't give such kind of results. Again, one more view. This is the mic I use. This is my Sony recorder. You can see how close and how sharp it is. And the whites really show some amount of purple fringing, but that is fine. You can see here the purple fringing here. Chromatic aberrations slightly. Now this is a normal view. I wanted to show you how far it is from a normal angle and how close you can get. Now this is again the normal angle view. Even the normal angle is very sharp. You can see it retains a lot of details. It's not bad at all. And this is your macro mode. Wow. Okay, this one was a leaf. This is the actual 1x zoom, and this is your macro mode, super macro mode. Oh my god, it's really sharp, and a lot of resolution is retained. It needs slightly more light, and indoor, these are shot indoors, and anyway, kids' photos are really difficult to take. And this is the best I could get actually. I took multiple tries, attempts to take capture eye and eyelashes. It was not sharp enough. This is only one tube light which was glowing overhead. So I tried to take some photos of my daughter's eyes, but I couldn't nail anything. This is one more photo. All the veins of the leaf has been nicely retained, and this was not very close actually to the subject. I could have gone further closer. So thank you guys, this was few of my collection of macro photography that I did, just to show you, not any kind of serious photography, but just to show the capabilities of this Mate 20 Pro lens. This is really phenomenal when it comes to smartphone photography. Very few lenses will come close to Mate 20 Pro right now in macro abilities. So thank you guys, if you enjoyed the video, do hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more such videos. Thank you, bye.